Hello students, welcome back once again. This is your English teacher Himanshi ma'am and we are doing chapter number 3 in the course book. That is the story titled Journey by Night and the author of the story is Nora Burke. Okay students, till now we have discussed so many things in so many video lessons regarding the story. Can you tell me what is the best part of the story enjoyed by you? I mean, most of you have already got the books and I'm sure you have done the reading of the chapter. I hope you have, right? And today we will come to the end of the story. Today we will find out what finally happens to those two brothers who have been going through this tough and challenging journey to reach Kalaghat to get to the hospital. But before we come to the ending, I want to ask from you, what is your favorite part of the journey taken by Sher Singh and his brother Kumar? You tell me that in the comment section. In today's comment section, in today's video lesson, you are going to tell me with your name, class and section that throughout the journey, in so many video lessons that all the points we have discussed, which part did you enjoy the most? What did you like the most about the journey and the experiences that they faced, both of them, Sher Singh and his brother Kumar, to reach Kalaghat? And today I will finally disclose and reveal what exactly happens to them. At the end of the story, what does the author has decided for the fate? But before we do any of that, what are the three things that you will first do? Okay, so first you are going to click on the like button. Quickly click on the like button. Then you are going to share this video and then you have to make sure that all of you are my subscribers. That's right. Students, you know, there is one more point that I want to discuss with all of you today. And that is, well, I am very happy that all of you are writing so many comments and queries and discussions in the comment box. And we all are in day-to-day basis communication. But have you all observed what you write? Have you all observed your spellings and your grammar and your tenses when you're writing those answers to me? I mean, I haven't started pointing out yet, but you know, at the same time, I'm observing everyone's spelling mistakes, tenses mistakes, which you do while you make your comments in the comment box. So beta, this is also a part of all the learning that you and I have done since so many days and so many years. You all are in 8th class now. Since so many years, you're doing tenses, you are practicing writing skills, spellings and so many things. And this is finally the result. So whenever you do write anything in the comment section, make sure that you reread. You reread all the comments you are writing. Check your spellings. You don't want to feel embarrassed in front of so many people. If somebody else apart from me reads your comment, you don't want anyone to feel that, oh, this student cannot even write the spelling properly. So this is what my advice for all of you goes today. That make sure whenever you're writing anything in the comment box, your spelling and your tenses both are accurate. Okay students, and I'm sure you all will do really well. I'm sure you always are in a hurry to just write it down and text to me in the comment box. But now, from now onwards, you will pay even more attention to what you are writing and how you are writing it. I'll be waiting for the correct use of grammar and spellings in the next video. I mean, in the this video itself. Okay, so students, let's come to the point. Where were we in the last video lesson? Can you remind me? Well, we were on the point where Sher Singh and Kumar had finally crossed all that river area and they had reached the shore. When they were completely exhausted, their bones, their whole body were tired. Sher Singh was almost going to fall down in exhaustion when he heard a noise. I think this is where we had stopped first, right? Okay, let's come back to that now. So when finally he heard that noise, what was that noise? That noise came from the people who were nearby. There were some people, some other villagers, probably, you know, of some other village across the river. They observed these two boys completely drenched in river water and tired and exhaustion on their faces. And they observed them down on their knees near the river banks. So they observed them and they came running towards Sher Singh and Kumar. Sher Singh observed that as soon as they came, they started asking so many questions. Who are you boys? Where have you come from? What are you doing here? What happened to you? Why is the little one on the back? They were asking so many questions. But Sher Singh was so exhausted in his mind and his body that he was barely able to say anything. So the other villagers who had come to save them. Yes, those villagers were going to save them. Finally, another miracle of nature. Some other strangers who were just passing by saw, watched them and saw that they needed help. So they came running towards them. So these villagers decided we better take both the brothers to the hospital, which was of course in Kalaghat, which was eventually the final destination of this journey, isn't it? So Sher Singh and Kumar were taken in a bullock cart. You all know what is a bullock cart, right? Villagers use that more often than cars and other things. So they were taken in a bullock cart up to a distance, and from there they were shifted into a truck with the help of those villagers, and finally they were taken to Kalaghat in the hospital. And immediately the medical staff, they caught hold of Kumar, who was originally the sick one, and they took him inside to get him treated while Sher Singh waited outside the hospital in a veranda. It was the open garden area veranda, and he was sitting there and waiting, completely tired. He had no idea, he had lost track of time. He had no idea what time it was, what day it was, because he was tired. He had been through a very challenging and difficult journey. He had survived very, very crucially, and he had not eaten anything since the previous day, previous evening. So there was so much going on in his mind that he hardly understood what was happening around him at that time. Then a doctor came out searching for Sher Singh. And you know what did he say? What were the exact words of the doctor? He said to Sher Singh, "Are you Sher Singh Bahadur?" This is what he said to him. Now students, let's come and put our focus on this. He said, "Are you Sher Singh Bahadur?" Then Sher Singh, the 12-year-old boy, replies that, "No, sir. That is the name of my father. My father is Sher Singh Bahadur. I am just Sher Singh." Then the doctor looks at that young boy and smiles at him and says, "Well, Sher Singh Bahadur, your brother will survive. He will live. Not to worry." Just one line, just these two statements with a broad smile, the doctor sums up the end, the conclusion of the story. The entire challenge of that journey by night taken by Sher Singh was so that he could save the life of his brother. And when the doctor said to him that your brother will survive, that meant that he was indirectly saying that you did a good job by bringing him to the hospital, and finally he will be given the proper treatment. And we have to focus on these dialogues again and again. The ending of the story is very crucial for the message which the author Nora Burke is trying to give us, the message which we have to capture from the story. The doctor says to the little boy, "Sher Singh Bahadur." You remember in the previous 2-3 videos, again and again I am putting emphasis on this point, that being the son of a father whose name was Sher Singh Bahadur, today through this experience of this journey, Sher Singh, the 12-year-old boy, was also proving to be a Bahadur boy himself. A brave, courageous boy, young boy, proving just like his own father. And the doctor proved it right. All the points which we were discussing regarding his courageous behavior since so many video lessons, in the final end of the story, the doctor proved our point right. That yes, Sher Singh, the 12-year-old boy, was indeed a brave, courageous, bold boy who took this harsh decision on himself to solely alone, all alone, travel through the night, through these dangerous locations, just to take his brother to Kalaghat where he could be treated in a hospital. And even the doctor asked me, "Are you coming from the Ladwani village?" So that was the name of his village, Ladwani, and the Kalaghat where they had to reach, and the distance was of 50 miles. So automatically the doctor understood, the doctor was smart enough to understand that this young boy must have gone through many, many difficulties to reach here. Because looking at his condition, how he's dressed and how he's looking and how exhausted his body looks, he could understand. That's why in the end, Nora Burke leaves the story at this statement where the doctor is saying, "Sher Singh Bahadur, your brother will survive." So students, this was the story of Sher Singh and his younger brother Kumar, who both together, hand in hand, went through this difficult, extremely challenging journey. They started the previous day during the sunset and they reached the next morning. Throughout the night time they were on a journey, they had to cross hurdles after hurdles, hurdles after hurdles. There were so many problems they had to keep on facing, and finally they reached their destination and finally they achieved their target. their goal. The goal was to get proper treatment for Kuwar, who was feeling extremely sick. So Nora Burke, the author, has given us an extremely important lesson of life. This story is first of all very entertaining, very mind-capturing. Even when I read that story before explaining to you, I felt very captured in the story because all the situations which happened and the characters who are just these two small boys, it's very interesting and very capturing. So first of all, it's very interesting, mind-capturing, and most importantly, Nora Burke gives a very important lesson of life, which is never to give up on your goals. It is very important to make up your mind if you want to achieve something. Sher Singh wanted to achieve one goal, that was to reach the hospital. And to achieve that goal, he did not give up throughout the problems he faced, not even once. What if he had given up when he saw those bear tracks in the evening? What if he had given up when he saw the elephants on the cliff? What if he had given up when he fell down from those slimy stones near the riverbank? What if he fell, he dropped when that broken bridge was there in front of him? What if he had given up? Then Kuwar would not have survived. His goal would not have been fulfilled. So students, this story is very important for you and me to remember that we have to focus on the struggle. Never to give up. Always and always have our eyes set on the target. Only then can we achieve our goals. And most importantly, have the strong willpower and mindset to achieve your targets and whatever struggle and hard work is required to fulfill it and achieve it. This was the story of Sher Singh, a 12-year-old boy who goes through multiple challenges, especially in the natural habitat surrounded by wild animals, to reach Kalaghat to get proper treatment for his little brother Kuwar, who was feeling sick. And at the end of the story, Nora Burke proved this point that just like father, Sher Singh was also a Bahadur. He could also be entitled as Sher Singh Bahadur. This was the end of chapter number 3, Journey by Night, written by Nora Burke. In today's video lesson, in the description box, I have given you some questions which you have to do based on our today's discussion. And continued with that, in the next video lesson, we will discuss a few more things. So stay tuned, keep watching the video lessons and keep doing your work regularly. And remember my today's advice. Make sure when you're writing any comment in the comment box, your spellings, your punctuation and your tenses are accurate in use. Okay, students, that's it for today. Take care. Bye-bye. See you soon.